Hello, this is Sophia from LitExtension. In this video, I'm going to cover the basics and guide you through the primary steps to set up a Shopify store. If you are considering replatforming your current website to Shopify, check out our video tutorial to perform the migration automatically, accurately, and safely. I put the link in the description box. Now let's get started. Typically, the first thing you need to do is signing up an account on Shopify. You just need to fill in your email address, password for your website, and a store name. Just simple as it is, you don't need to provide any credit card details. Next, you have to provide Shopify a little bit about yourself. It's not too important, so you can go through this part quickly. Hit the button next. From here, I'm going to put more information about myself. After that, hit enter my store and you will land on the admin area of your store. From this dashboard, you are able to navigate to every important place that you will need to manage your store. The homepage will be the first thing that you see. Here you can find various pieces of information such as your recent activities, total sales, and some recommendations. Next, there are sections to manage the core of your business activities, which are orders, products, and customers. About the analytics right here, from the overview dashboard, you get a big picture of the sale information of your store. You can rely on the statistics to optimize your site so that you can generate as many sales as possible. Going down to report, you can see an overall macro finances, your marketing spending. And then we have live view to see how many people are on your website right now, how much money you got today. Going down to marketing, there are three main parts: overview, campaign, and automations. You can see a marketing overview, create and manage marketing campaigns right here, and install more marketing apps if you want to. Going down to discount, you can create some discount codes or have some automatic discounts right here. It can be a percentage discount, free shipping, or buy one get one. Then we have apps with so many powerful apps right here. You can click visit the Shopify App Store to discover more great apps to boost the performance of your online store. Shopify allows you to easily integrate and sell your products across multiple channels other than just online store. When clicking on the plus sign, point of sale, Facebook Shop, and Messenger will appear as they are the featured sales channel. Apps are applications bought from the Shopify App Store and installed on your account. On the top of the dashboard, there is a search bar that you can use to find product SKUs, pages, or other details in your Shopify admin. Now let's go into more details on what you need to set up to launch an online store. The first step to do is adding products on the store. Select product on the left sidebar, then click add a product to start creating the first product. We need to add the title or name of your product. Let's just say you want a checkered dress as your first product. And next, you may want to write the description that attracts as many potential customers as possible. Then add images to show your products. Product images can make sales, so make sure you show your products in the best possible way. You should keep all images of the same size to keep your store looking neat. Now head down to pricing to set the price for your product. Then Shopify will show you what your profit margin is and how much profit you get per item. Next, fill in your stock keeping unit. You can have a barcode for that. Let's just say it's ST1, and then provide the number of the products your store is having. After that, you can set multiple options for your products such as different colors, different size, and any kind of variants. Don't forget to edit SEO. You should optimize how your product page is shown on the search results to maximize click-through rate. Pay attention to title, description, and URL. Once everything is filled out, please remember to click the Save Product button in the top and bottom right corners. Let's head to the next step, which is selecting and customizing your Shopify store. It's pretty simple that it shows you what it's gonna look like basically. If you do not like the free theme, you can check the free themes provided and add your favorite one to the theme library. You can also buy some themes from the Shopify store. There are lots of nice and not expensive themes out there, but in this video, I'm gonna choose this free theme. Let's start editing a route. You need to click Customize Theme button to be taken to the page that controls all the basic functionalities of the theme. On the left side, there is a list of sections such as Image with Text, Feature Collection, Feature Product, Image with Text. In each session, you can upload images and edit the text until you're satisfied with the final look of your Shopify store. In particular, Feature Collection is a very interesting section if you want to promote your high-profit products or products you're confident with selling. In particular, the Shopify theme also ensures mobile responsiveness, that this helps your store look good on all devices and resolution. To see the preview of how your Shopify store looks with that theme, you can click this button and then click Publish to complete the theme setup. There is much more to choose and activate before you can go live with your store. You can access all of these options from your store settings area. Here, you can fill in some general information about your business like name, address, phone number to provide your store's information for Shopify. Next, the location helps you manage the inventory, fulfill orders, and sell products. Click Add Location if your store has more than one location. Those locations can be retail stores, warehouses, sellers, or anywhere else related to inventory. Remember that Shopify allows you to set 1-4 locations in the basic Shopify plan. Click Compare Plan to see the number of locations allowed by Shopify. About shipping, you definitely have to decide which delivery methods are most suitable for your store before going live. Thereafter, your customers are allowed to choose any one of those methods at the checkout page. To set up the shipping, first, click Create New Profile to add the shipping address to get an accurate shipping rate based on your store's location. The next step to do is creating shipping zones to ship to different regions, states, and countries. Then, click Add Rate to configure the shipment dimensions if you're using carrier calculated shipping rates. Many carriers use volumetric weights like the height, weight, and the depth of a package to calculate shipping rates. You should plan a shipping strategy that works best for your business, and then click the button Save. The checkout page is where payment occurs. You can also easily modify the appearance and layout of the checkout page in theme setting. Here, you will be able to allow customers to create customer accounts so that password-protected information such as address, email, and other history are stored and pre-filled at checkout. And about payments of Shopify, you can enable a number of payment options for your customers' convenience. Shopify offers its own payment provider, which is Shopify Payments, along with a wide range of supported third-party payment providers. If you haven't set up any credit card payment provider on your account, click on Complete Account Setup in the Shopify Payments section. Provide Shopify your credit card details, then click Complete Account Setup. Click Choose Third-Party Provider in the Third-Party Providers section. Select the provider that you want to use from the list. You can only enable one credit card payment provider at a time. If you already have one, Shopify allows you to change it to another. Please enter your account credentials for the provider that you selected and click Activate. Don't forget that Shopify Payments will not be displayed for countries which are not supported by Shopify Payments. So if your country is not supported by Shopify Payments, choose a third-party provider instead. Laws of most countries require you to collect tax on sales of products and remit them to the government. Shopify makes this easy for you by handling most common tax calculations in many tax jurisdictions. Now you're one step away from going live with your store, adding your domain to Shopify. To help you set up a store, Shopify assigns a default domain, www.yourstorename.myshopify.com. Besides, if you want a more customized URL such as www.bentomarket.com for better brand recall in your customers' minds or to rank better in a search, you can buy a domain from Shopify and it will be added to your store automatically. This saves your time, especially if you have no knowledge about hosting a website. These domains typically cost from $9 to $14 per year. Besides, you can click Transfer Domain to connect the domain that you purchased on the previous site to the new site without a penny. So now, congratulations! Finally, you have a fully working Shopify store. Basically, that's all of how to create a Shopify store. In case you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment in the comment box below. Thank you for watching our video. After watching this video, are you ready to set up your own Shopify store? The best time to do it is now. I will put the link of the free trial in the description box. You can get started and have your website up by today. Please leave a comment down below to share your experiences of setting up Shopify. Let me know if you would like to recommend us about all the topics for our video. Don't forget to follow LitExtension for more interesting e-commerce platforms videos and shopping cart migration tutorials. If you intend to migrate all your data of your online store from one e-commerce platform to another one and vice versa, contact us on the link below. See you next time!